Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can use the jfilechooser class in Java to select a file someplace within your computer, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright people, let's just get right into this. So we're going to be discussing the jfilechooser class. This is a GUI mechanism that lets a user choose a file. We're only going to be selecting a file today. I have other videos on loading files and saving files. So this is helpful for opening or saving files if you want to look for a file that's someplace within your computer or within your project folder. So let me show you my setup real quick. I have two classes, a main class and then a MyFrame class. I have a new instance of MyFrame within my main class. MyFrame extends JFrame, implements the action listener interface. I have a constructor called MyFrame. This.setDefaultClose operation, JFrame exit on close. I'm using a new flow layout, this.pack, and this.setVisible to true. Now to launch the jfilechooser, we're probably going to need a button. So let's create a button to do so. So let's say jbutton button equals new jbutton. And I'll add some text, maybe select, or better yet, select file. All right. And then I want to add an action listener to this button, so button.addActionListener. Since this class is implementing the action listener interface, I just pass in this, and then we need to add this button to the frame. So this.add. And we're adding the button. Alright, so we need to check if we are clicking this button, then we're going to launch an event. So if e.getSource is equal to our button. However, this action performed method does not recognize this button, so we need to declare this outside of our constructor. So jButton button, and then we do not need to declare this twice. All right, so when we click on our button, and let's just try this real quick. So we have our button and it says select file in the top corner. So we are going to launch a new instance of our jfilechooser class. So in order to do that, we need to first declare it jfilechooser. And we will call this file chooser equals new j file chooser. All right, so now if we were to run this and we click on select file, it currently doesn't do anything. Well, that's because we didn't set it up to do anything yet. We only declared and created a new instance of file chooser. So the next step is that we are going to either show open dialog or show save dialog. We're not actually going to be opening or saving any files, just getting the location for the file. So let's go with show open dialog, and then I'll show you show save dialog right after. So in order to do that, to open our dialog menu, it is the name of our file chooser right here, dot show either open dialog or save dialog. Let's just go with open. All right, and then if you have a parent component, you place that in here, but we don't have one, so we're just going to put null for now. So what this does is that I'm going to add a comment. This will select file to open. All right. So I currently have a file on my desktop, and this is what this currently looks like. It's going to bring you to your default directory of where you usually open files, and I have a file on my desktop, and it is called Hello World. All right, so you can select a file to open, and there's different files of type where you can search through these, but I'll show you that later. So let's say we want to open this file. Well, where is it? All right, so there's a few other steps. So with filechooser.showOpenDialog, it's going to return an integer value. Think of it as the response. And I'll actually print this with a println statement. So system.out.println, and I'm going to place this within the println statement. And I just want to show you what this returns exactly. All right, so I'm going to go to my desktop. And then I'm going to attempt to open this file again. So open. Okay, so this returns zero. So that's kind of like the response based on what button we click. If I were to click cancel, it's going to return one. Or if I click X, it's going to return one as well. So we can actually do something with this. Perhaps we can store this within a variable. So I'm going to create an integer variable called response. Int response equals filechooser.showOpenDialog. And then we can check to see if response is equal to zero. But there's another way of writing this. If response is equal to zero, that's one way. Or what we could do is write jfilechooser.approveOption, and that would be better. So if somebody successfully selects a file and does not click cancel or click X button, then we can actually create a new file. We can store that. So let's declare a new file. File equals new file. And the file path for this is going to be filechooser.getSelectedFile.getAbsoluteMath. All right. And then we'll probably need an import for this file as well. Okay, then let's print the file path for this file. So we can do that with system.out.println, and we're going to place the file name here. So then what happens is that when we select a file, let's say I want to go back to my desktop and select that Hello World file. This is going to get the file path, and currently it's on my desktop. So we don't necessarily need this print line statement, but it's just proving that this file actually has a location too. So then I have other videos on loading a file or saving a file using scanners or print writers, but we'll save that for another video. Actually, I think I'm going to keep this print line statement just because we have more to do. Okay, now we have show save dialog. Currently with show open dialog, we can select a file to open and we have an open button. Alternatively, we have show save dialog. So that is filechooser.showSaveDialog. So I'm going to change open to save, and I'll just turn this first line into a comment because we don't really need it anymore. So this will select file to save. All right, it's the same process as before really, but now we have this save button and we can attempt to save a file, but there's still more steps we have to follow for actually creating a file. I have a separate video on that. So if I wanted to save something to my desktop, this could be testfile.txt. Then I'm going to click save. Currently, this won't actually create a file, but here it's just printing the file location and it's set to my desktop. All right, so that is show save dialog. Now, one other thing that we could do too is that we can set the current directory, because right now it's just going to the default for my computer, and that is my documents folder, and we can actually change that. So in order to do that, it is filechooser.setCurrentDirectory, and we pass in a new file, and we specify the file path within this new file. So one trick, if you want to place this within, set the current directory to your project folder, that would be just a dot within quotes. So this is going to go to my project folder, and the project name is GUI Swing. So you can see that that changed. Otherwise, I could place a file path here. So if I wanted the current directory by default to be set to my desktop, I would place the file path for my desktop. And for my desktop, this is the address. Now, if I were to run this and select a file, the default directory is now my desktop and I can attempt to open or save a file here. Well, that's the basics of the jfilechooser class, and in a future video, we're actually going to be creating a text editor app and we'll need to use the jfilechooser class. So if you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the jfilechooser class in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.